Welcome to this week's Artist on Art, and you are tuned in to KZSC Santa Cruz. I am your host, Nada Milkovich. I have the great pleasure of speaking with Jayme Kelly Curtis today. Now you're wondering, well, why did they play the William Coulter? Well, you're going to find out in just a few minutes. First of all, I want to say thanks and welcome Jayme Kelly Curtis. Jayme, thanks so much for coming in.
Thank you, Nada.
Jayme is a Santa Cruz songwriter, performer, singer.
Yes.
She is amazing, plays all kinds of stringed instruments.
Well, a few.
And you can see a lot of her work at Pearl, Purr Girl.
Purr. Like the kitty cat.
PURRGIRL.com. Jayme Kelly Curtis has been here in Santa Cruz for a couple decades now.
Yeah.
And we are so lucky. Jayme is here not just to talk about her music, but in fact, we're here to talk about an incredible exhibition and festival that's about to begin on February 7th, and that's the Santa Cruz County Art of Guitar Exhibit and Festival.
Yay! You got all those words out. It's a long title.
It is. And then we'll throw in
Luthiers.
Luthiers!
From the word lute.
From the word lute. And we're going to be exploring guitars and luthiers, or Lutheries.
Lutherie, uh-huh.
For the plural. So what's amazing to me is that Jayme has been working on this exhibit and festival for 4 years now.
Just about, yeah. That's about, I started thinking about it in 4 years ago, and 3 years ago I started thinking about it seriously, and 2 years ago I started actually putting the wheels in motion to make it happen.
And it's quite an amazing festival. It begins, you say, February 1st.
February 1st, the gala kickoff.
The gala kickoff, which is happening at the Museum of Art and History?
No. In fact, it's happening, the exhibit itself is at the R. Blitzer Gallery for 6 weeks.
At the R. Blitzer Gallery, which can be found in what we call the old Wrigley Building?
That is correct.
Or the OW Building, mm-hmm, off of Mission Extension.
Mission Extension, 2801 Mission Extension.
And it's an incredible, beautiful gallery, very large space, mm-hmm, in what used to be the Wrigley
Chewing Gum Factory.
Chewing Gum,
right?
Factory. It still smells. Yes. Like in the stairwells, I still smell it. Maybe it's
the
just
ghosts
me
of factory workers past.
Yeah, it makes me want to chew some gum. And so the gala event, which everybody wants to come out to, is Saturday, February 1st. What time does that start at? That starts at 5.
It does start at 5. I've been telling everybody to come at 7, but you can get there earlier. But we're going to have music, live music, starting at 6, and it will go to 9 o'clock. And it's a great opportunity to see the exhibit, which we'll get into in a minute, about what this is all about. And you can meet some of Santa Cruz's renowned luthiers, who were the source of my inspiration for doing this.
And then at the gala event at the R. Blitzer Gallery on Saturday, February 1st, starting between 5 and 6, mm-hmm, Santa Cruz time, mm-hmm, and running till 9, you'll have two wonderful guitar players, Bill Walker,
yes,
and Ron Wilson.
Correct. So far, we'll probably have at least one more person, but we haven't booked them yet.
And you'll be able to have an intimate viewing of these incredible, exquisitely, locally made,
yes,
Lutherie.
Guitars.
Oh,
yes. Guitars.
And it's a very little known fact, and it's a very interesting fact, that Santa Cruz has an amazing number of world-renowned luthiers.
That is correct.
And you you talk about how this was something that inspired you to start planning for this exhibit and festival 4 years ago. Mm-hmm. Tell us about how, you being a guitar player, how you fell into this crowd.
Right. Well, you know, I think a lot of people know that there are a lot of luthiers in Santa Cruz, because there's one in particular, the Santa Cruz Guitar Company, that is world famous. Their guitars are played by the likes of Eric Clapton, the Waybacks. You know, famous people play their instruments. I'm sure Richard Hoover, the brains behind the Santa Cruz Guitar Company, is going, mention so-and-so. And, of course, I'm having a blank. But lots and lots of famous people play their guitars. So if you're at all involved in music and the Santa Cruz music scene, you probably are aware of Santa Cruz Guitar Company. You probably know, perhaps, of the Hill Guitar Company, Kenny Hill's company. If you've ever driven up Highway 9, you've seen that shingle. If you're really into it, you might be aware that Rick Turner has his Renaissance Guitar Company here. His guitars are played by people like Lindsey Buckingham and Jesse Colin Young. And, you know, you might even be aware of a few others.
Rick McKee of Guitar Works.
Well, Rick McKee happens to be my sweetheart, who's better known as Ukulele Dick. And he's also a guitar repairman, has been fixing guitars and building guitars since the early 70s. And this was what astonished me. As connected as I am with the music scene and the Lutherie scene in Santa Cruz, it wasn't until 4 years ago that I happened on an event that made me realize that there were far more world-renowned, highly admired high-end guitar builders here in Santa Cruz. And that was the event that really blew my mind and started me thinking, we need to do something to shine a light on this extraordinary community, because it really is astonishing for a community of our size to have as many well-respected luthiers as we do.
And what was that event, Jayme?
Well, there's... in the guitar world, in the music merchandising world, there are trade shows. And there were actually two events that that were pivotal events for me. One of them was the Healdsburg Guitar Festival, which is actually in Santa Rosa. It started in Healdsburg, but it's in Santa Rosa. And I was up there a few years ago, 4 years ago. And that event is very much geared to commerce. And it's all about buying and selling guitars, and it's a very insider kind of crowd. And I happened to be there, and I was looking through their program book, and I was like, oh, there's Kenny Hill, there's Richard Hoover, Santa Cruz Guitar Company, people that I know well. But all of a sudden, I started noticing there were all these names and addresses of luthiers from Santa Cruz that I didn't even know about. People like Scott Walker, whose guitars are played by the likes of Steve Kimmock from the band Zero. Matthew Mustapick is a wonderful builder. Ed Claxton was somebody that I did not know. Steven Strom. There's just this whole smorgasbord of people I had no idea that were based here in Santa Cruz. And the other, so I thought that was really interesting. But there was another event kind of along the same lines. January is the time of year when a lot of music merchandisers and people that are commercially involved in the music industry go down to L.A. for a trade show called NAMM, the National Association of Music Merchandisers. And this is a big, big trade show. Throngs and throngs of people at the Anaheim Convention Center. And I was down there through a connection, because they don't allow civilians in, but I happened to have been there. And the Santa Cruz Guitar Company was celebrating their 10,000th guitar off the line, I think. I'm notoriously bad with numbers, so it could have been 100,000, but I think it was 10,000. And they had built this extraordinary guitar. It was just beautiful. It has a lot of inlay on it, and it's encrusted with jewels, and it's a priceless instrument. But the way that they had it displayed was what really got me thinking. It was in a museum-quality display case under glass. So here I am in the midst of throngs of jostling people, being able to observe and look at the intimate details of this wonderful instrument really up close without any worry of damaging it. And no one was standing over me, hovering, saying, be careful, don't let your zipper scratch the back of that instrument. Oh. But I could see every part of it. And I thought, somebody has to do this to let the general public see and experience the details of these guitars, because they really are works of art. And unless you're a player or a collector, i.e. wealthy, or somehow involved in the music industry, you really don't get a chance to see these details. And they really are detailed.
Jayme Kelly Curtis is here at KZSC on Artist on Art to talk about the Santa Cruz County Art of Guitar Exhibit and Festival, which begins Saturday, February 1st, at the R. Blitzer Gallery. That will be the grand opening, and you'll be able to, as you say, view the exquisiteness of mm-hmm. these locally made guitars.
Right.
Then the next event in this series of festivals, which is a month and a half long.
Yes, 6 weeks long. You'll have an opportunity to go to the gallery, the R. Blitzer Gallery, and view the exhibit for 6 weeks. But there's other things going on for 6 weeks as well.
So then the following Friday, which is February 7th, and my favorite day of the month, first Friday.
Here, here.
The Santa Cruz Art Tour. There will be a exhibition and show, basically, at the Museum of Art and History, starting at 5 o'clock, running to 9, and that event at the MA will be 14 world-class guitarists. Is that correct?
I think there are 14, yes, something like that.
So they are going to show off these exquisite guitars that have been designed and built in Santa Cruz County on the main stage in the main MA atrium. Mm-hmm. And you get to start off the show at 6 o'clock.
Yes, I happen to play a locally made instrument by Tony Graziano.
And then we have Kenny Hill.
Yes.
The creator of the Hill Guitar Company.
Who's also a wonderful classical guitarist in and of his own right.
And then we have, at 6:30, Ben Bording.
Yes. I don't have the list in front of me. Whose guitars is he showing?
Ben will be showing Matthew
Mustapick.
Mustapick guitars.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have Bob Basa.
Who's playing, I believe, Andrew Sacco, who is the only builder in Santa Cruz making archtop guitars, for those of you keeping count.
And what is an archtop guitar?
An archtop guitar is where the top of it is actually bowed in an arch. And you'll typically see jazz players. Probably the most famous archtop guitars are made by Gibson Guitar Company. And they're especially well suited to the jazzy comping style. So that's the other thing that really blew my mind about just the sheer number of luthiers in Santa Cruz County is also the musical diversity. The instruments that they're making are for lots of different kinds of musicians.
Oh, yeah. Hence why we started with William Coulter.
Yes.
At the beginning of the show, off of the album Song for Our Ancestors, that was him playing Drops of Brandy.
I think he's got Benjamin Verdry on that record with him, too.
And you're correct. You've got a great mind. Jayme Kelly Curtis doing
Thank
it
you,
out
Nada.
Here. And then we've got David Winter. He's going to be starting at 7. Again, we're still talking about the February 7th event, first Friday event at the MA, Exploring Guitars and Lutherie Friday. That's next Friday. We've got at 7 o'clock David Winter.
Winters.
Oh, okay.
Is this him? I need to fix that.
That's okay. And he's playing on a Fred Carlson harp guitar.
Yes.
What's a harp guitar?
Well, it's basically a guitar that has an extra appendage on it that gives you several more strings. Mm-hmm. And in fact, Fred is one of the more unusual luthiers in Santa Cruz County.
Why is that?
Well, because he is a really highly skilled luthier, but he is also an artistic explorer in other realms. And he really kind of creates instruments that are melding between guitar building and sculpture. In fact, he's working on something very, very special right now that will have its world premiere at the R. Blitzer Gallery. And that'll be on March 1st. It's an instrument that he's calling the Humanitar.
The Humanitar.
The Humanitar will be played. It's Fred's attempt to anthropomorphize the instrument, and it's human scale. It actually stands on one leg. It has arms and legs and a head. It's kind of whimsical. And
when is he?
That instrument will be on display for the full 6 weeks at the R. Blitzer Gallery. But on March 1st, we will have the renowned guitarist Alex Degrassi play the Humanitar. And then William Coulter's also in that concert, and Evan Herschelman, who will be playing Hill guitars, is in that concert. It's one of many concerts that we have scheduled for this shindig.
Yeah, and so we just need to tell everybody, if you need to see, if you need to find out where and what all of these wonderful events are, not only can you go to artistonart.com, you'll be able to see it there, but you also have it
at SantaCruzLutherie.org.
That's right.
That's LutherieS.org.
SantaCruzLutherie.org. And so we're still working on the February 7th show.
Right, back at the Ma.
back at the Ma.
And let's call that a focus on Lutherie. It's not really an exhibit, just to...
It's a musical event.
It's a musical event, but there's also a lot of other things going on that night that are focused on the craft and the art and craft and science of Lutherie.
So you'll be able to enjoy the concert, grab a drink at the No Host Bar, check out the following displays and activities. And so Kenny Hill will show you how to make.
Yes, they're actually setting up a bench, and we'll do a luthier exhibition of the whole process of building guitars.
And there'll be a slideshow bistro where you can relax with food and drink while you enjoy a slideshow of portraits of local luthiers by Jim McKenzie and Renee Flower.
Yes.
And then there'll be a guitar strap weaving demonstration.
Yes,
for all you.
Annie McHale.
So you can DIY your guitar strap. Then you have a second string project collection point, so you can bring your sets of used guitar strings to be distributed to musicians in undeveloped areas of the world.
Yes, and let me just reiterate that for you musicians out there, if you are changing your strings on your guitar, keep them, put them in the original packages if you can, but keep them together in sets, and we will be a collection point for the second string project. And you may ask, why would anybody want my used guitar strings? Well, standards are different in different parts of the world. One man's trash is another man's treasure. There are places in, for example, in Africa where people are making their own stringed instruments, but it's really hard to get strings. So even a used set of strings is like gold there. It's a really nice way to recycle your strings.
And then the last of many activities, which I think is going to be really fun, is called Adam's Art Project. And
yes.
This is where you're making a guitar-shaped pendant from tone wood with Finnish expert Adam Stark.
Yeah, so that's really geared to the kids, but kids from 1 to 92. It's designed. Adam is the guy that does a lot of he shoots a lot of the finishes for various luthiers in town. And we'll have these little pieces of guitar-shaped rare tone wood. So it really illustrates the process of how a piece of wood becomes the thing of beauty that it does by virtue of different stains. And we won't be shooting nitrocellular finishes or varnish, but we'll be doing some stains that are easy to see a difference
and
dry fast.
Let's just quickly finish the schedule of the Santa Cruz County Exploring Guitars and Lutherie event at the Ma on February 7th, which is part of the Santa Cruz First Friday Art Tour. We had Tess, Dunn, and Rory Freeman will be playing on
Jeff Traugott guitars.
And Tess, Dunn, and Rory are both young singer-songwriters.
You know, I know Tess as a piano player. I mean, I don't know her personally, but I've seen her perform
a
piano player. But she either plays guitar or the person, who is it, Rory?
Rory.
He must play guitar. I don't know. Jeff Traugott set that up. So he's one of one of the most renowned guitar builders in the world. David Crosby has famously referred to his instruments as scrumptious. So
that's Jeff Traugott's scrumptious guitars, played by Tess Dunn and Rory Freeman. Then we've got Robbie Eckhart.
Yes, he's playing a David Morse guitar, I believe.
And then,
David is better known as a violin builder, but he has, in his career, made some exquisite instruments, so we're very lucky to have Robbie Eckert playing one of them.
And then William Coulter, who we're going to play in just a few seconds here, from the Santa Cruz Guitar Company guitars. And then we've got Patty Maxine, Colin Alder, and Ron Wilson, and they're going to be playing Cruz Tone Lap steel guitars and Rick Turner Renaissance guitars.
Right. Patty, of course, is very well known in Santa. She's probably the hardest working lap steel player in town.
With the best hair.
With the best hair. Right. And, you know, gathers a crowd wherever she goes. And Colin Alder makes a kind of lap steel guitar called, his own line is the Cruz Tone. So she'll be playing on one of his instruments, and he will play with her. And then, of course, Ron Wilson is a perennial favorite, and he owns several locally made guitars
in particular the Rick Turner Renaissance guitar.
And then the last person playing is Bill Walker on a Scott Walker guitar.
That's right. And I think we're actually going to have one more person that we're going to shoehorn in there. But there's one more event going on. I don't know if it made it onto that schedule, but at 5 o'clock, there will be a lecture and demonstration of harmonics and the physics of music. David Winters is also an author exploring that realm. So
Wonderful. Yeah. That's February 7th at 5 p.m. at the Santa Cruz Museum of Art and History. That will be next Friday, part of the Santa Cruz First Friday Art Tour. And we're talking about the Santa Cruz County Art of Guitar Exhibit and Festival. I'm here with you, your host, Nada Milkovich, and I've got the lovely Jayme Kelly Curtis, a singer, songwriter, performer in her own right, and the creator and producer of this wonderful festival. You are listening to KZSC Santa Cruz. So let's put on a little more William Coulter.
Okay.
And you get a little bit of a sneak preview of what you'll be able to hear on February 7th. So I have to just talk for a little bit?
Sure.
Okay. I just have to say two things, and then we'll get back to you, and then we've done the first one, now there's only like five more, okay, then we got Saturday, from Loop to You,
right,
and then the 11th is the concert at the gallery with a special surprise guest. Segue to bring back our guest today on Artists on Art, Jayme Kelly Curtis. What a great PSA.
I didn't write that, but I'm delighted.
It's very well done. We've got William Coulter in the background, and William is one of the performers of at the Exploring Guitars in Lutherie on February 7th, next Friday. Right. And so we got through part of the exhibit. Actually, we only got into the first week. It's 6 weeks
right,
long
of the festival.
So, Jayme, this is just such an incredible lineup that you've done here.
I'm excited about it. It's all fallen into place.
It's amazing. And so what I want to talk about next is Saturday, after the Friday, big, amazing event, and then, of course, February 1st, the gala opening event.
Right.
We've got February 8th on Saturday. It's from lute to uke.
Yes, that's the Santa Cruz Baroque Society, or Baroque Festival.
What? The Baroque has ukes?
They do now.
I didn't know a ukulele was a Baroque instrument.
Well, it's been very interesting. You know, I've been listening to Ukulele Dick prepare his very pedantic lecture on this subject, and it's quite amusing.
I can't wait. I want to get this connection. And so this is the Santa Cruz Baroque Festival's historic journey through world of guitar family, featuring mm-hmm. performance by Tim Rayborn, John Schneiderman, and Ukulele Dick.
Yes.
As well as there'll be some historic instruments on display mm-hmm. by the luthier Paul Hostetter.
Hostetter, yes. And some ukuleles.
So that's on Saturday, and that starts at 7:30.
Right, that's at the recital hall on campus.
Oh, it's here mm-hmm. in the San... Okay,
yeah.
UCS.
Yep.
On campus at the recital hall. Where is that, Jayme?
The other side of the campus from where we are now.
On the west side?
It's over by, when you go to Shakespeare Center, by the Festival Glen. It's up there.
Okay, so it's by the theater mm-hmm. department.
Right.
Then on Tuesday, February 11th at 8 p.m., there's a concert at the gallery, the R. Blitzer
Gallery. Yeah.
With who?
Oh, this is a special surprise guest.
A special
surprise
guest.
Someone whose name I cannot mention, but it would behoove you to turn up that night.
So, Jayme Kelly Curtis, can you give us a hint?
I can tell you that it's someone who has another concert in the area, so that's why we're keeping it under wraps, because we don't want to sabotage for that person's other
concert. I heard a hint.
And by the way, if you are someone who is performing locally on a locally made guitar, I will post your gig for free on the Santa Cruz Luthiers.org website. So just send me an email, Jayme, which is Jayme, at purrgirl.com. If you can give it to me in the format that's already there, check the website. I'll be glad to cut and paste that onto our calendar for you.
Jayme Kelly Curtis, she is an artist activist for the Santa Cruz Lutherie community, and she is showing it through her amazing Santa Cruz County Art of Guitar exhibit and festival. So, February 11th, folks, that's a Tuesday at 8 p.m. at the R. Blitzer Gallery, mm-hmm. a special surprise guest. I'm showing up. For sure. I'm putting that on my calendar. This Thursday, February 20th, you have Bill Walker and Chris Mallett in concert again at the R. Blitzer Gallery.
Yes. Okay, that just came through. William Coulter's been a great help to me in helping me book some of these concerts. And by the way, he is on the music staff here at UCSC. He's the guitar teacher here.
That's wonderful.
So Chris Mallett, you're going to have to refresh my memory because I don't have the same information in front of me that you do, but
he's playing guitars by... I'm sorry. I lost it for a second. The Rick Turner Renaissance Guitar Company and Gilles Carnell.
Oh, Gilles Carnell. He's Gilles Carnell, yes. Okay.
And then so that's on February 20th, February 21st, which is a Friday, and running through Sunday, February 23rd, at the Santa Cruz Art League, you will have the instrument, the classical Baroque guitar and instrument exhibit by the luthier Charles Sutton.
Yes, and I'm glad you mentioned that date because it's not quite right. 21st, they gave me that date, but it's actually a setup date. The exhibit at the Art League runs through the 22nd and the 23rd. And Charles Sutton is a very interesting local luthier who makes historical replicas of classical guitars, but he also builds a lot of other instruments from the Baroque and the Renaissance eras. So he is having his own exhibit at the Art League. That's the one down on Broadway. And that exhibit will focus on just instruments that he has made. He'll be in the main exhibit too at the Art Blitzer Gallery, but some of his other historical kinds of instruments will be on display at the Art League. And I believe he also has a concert. What night is that? Is that
the concert is that February 23rd?
That's Carlitos de Santa Cruz, the flamenco singer, and the guitarist Guillermo Rios at that same venue. So you can see that exhibit as well.
And that's, again, February 23rd. It's a Sunday at 7 p.m. Mm-hmm. And then on Saturday, March 1st, at 8 p.m., we have Alex Degrassi, Evan Herschelman, and William Coulter in concert at the R. Blitzer Gallery.
Right. And that's the one where Alex Degrassi will be offering the world premiere of Fred Carlson's Humanitar. It's very unusual human-scale harp guitar hybrid type instrument, as well as the other guitars in his collection. And Evan Herschelman is sponsored by Kenny Hill Guitars, and William Coulter, of course, plays the Santa Cruz Guitar Company guitar, beautiful, beautiful instruments. And he also, I believe, owns a guitar by Jeff Traugott. So we're covering a lot of territory there. And anytime you come to one of the concerts at the exhibit, of course, you can take in the exhibit too.
Yes. And then we have Thursday, March 6th, the Athens Guitar Duo in concert, at the R. Blitzer Gallery, mm-hmm. plus the guitarist David Winters.
Yes. And by the way, on any of these concerts at the gallery, the seating there is very, very limited. So most of them are first come, first serve. The March 1st concert with Alex Degrassi, there are tickets available on brown paper tickets.
Okay, excellent. Then we've got Thursday, March 13th, the guitar poet Brian Gore in concert at the R. Blitzer Gallery.
Yes.
And that will be highlighting Carter Polson guitars.
Right. Willie Carter and Eric Polson have teamed up to create a wonderful line of guitars that they were one of the ones I wasn't aware of. I knew Willie Carter because he worked at Griffin Stringed Instruments over at in Palo Alto for many years, and it was when I went up to that trade show at Healdsburg and saw their name in the program. I was like, I didn't know they started a company and were offering their guitars for sale, and they've been very, very successful.
Wow, that's wonderful.
Yeah, I think it really speaks to the community of luthiers here in Santa Cruz. It's very a lot of cross-pollination going on in that artistic space. I heard Richard Hoover a couple weeks ago say that historically, guitar building was done in guilds, and it was very, very exclusive, and people didn't share their secrets. But here in Santa Cruz, it's much more democratic, and the luthiers here really value the community. And I think that's part of the reason that we have so many guitar builders here, is because there's this great community and exchange of ideas.
So do you think there was a couple luthiers who came, and then they brought their friends that are luthiers? Like, it's so interesting that we have this small community, 60,000
right.
people, and that we have this
right.
number of world
yes.
renowned luthiers.
Yeah, I think you really kind of hit the nail on the head there. There's a man named Jim Patterson. Jim, if you're listening, I really need to talk to you, and I don't know how to get in touch with you, but he is literally the old man of the mountain who inspired people like Richard Hoover and Kenny Hill back in the days, in the early 70s, when Rick McKee came out here, Kenny Hill will tell you, well, we were all hippies. We were all hippies in this kind of back to the land, back to nature, back to homespun craft movement. A lot of these people were who got into building guitars. And then Richard Hoover in particular, well, both he and Kenny Hill have spawned a lot of other builders through their tutelage and mentoring.
And their type of guild.
And their own type of guild.
Their hippie guild.
Their hippie guild. That's right.
You gotta love it. So there's so much information, folks. And, of course, if you missed any part of this, please go to santacruzluthiers.org. Again, that's L-U-T-H-I-E-R-S. And you'll be able to get the amazing number of events that are happening. You can also look at Jayme Kelly Curtis's website at purrgirl.com, and you can see her work, and we're going to play a little bit of her music at the end of this show today. So the Santa Cruz County Art of Guitar Exhibit and Festival event is happening, and it begins February 1st with the beginning of this 6-week long exhibition at the Arblitzer Gallery over right. on the Wrigley Old Wrigley Building.
On the west side.
On the west side at the Mission Extension, mm-hmm. the OW Building as well.
Between Swift and Western.
And then the grand opening is happening again February 1st, and you want to get there between 5 and 6 o'clock, and there will be a concert.
It goes until 9 o'clock. It's really kind of background music for that, because it's that night is really all about meeting the luthiers and mingling, socializing, and seeing the actual exhibit, which if I could talk about that for just a moment.
Of course.
The way we're all of us who are involved in this project are starting to get really excited about the way the exhibit itself is shaping up. We've got, I'm so blessed to have some amazing artists who are able to make this exhibit a piece of art in and of itself. Rob Blitzer, who's the curator at that gallery, is a very talented artist and has a wonderful eye for how things should be exhibited. And my own sweetheart, Rick McKee, a.k.a. Ukulele Dick, is an award-winning artist in his own right. And we have designed together a way to exhibit these instruments that is, I feel, a worthwhile frame for this art.
Wonderful.
It's unusual, and I think people will be surprised when they see it.
And then we have a whole series of February 7th, Friday, from 6 to 9. Well, actually, it starts at 5. The mm-hmm. Museum of Art and History, first Friday, mm-hmm. will be doing the Exploring Guitars and Lutherie. And at 5 o'clock, Ukulele Dick is going to be giving us a...
No, I'm sorry. That's the harmonics. That's the night after. At 5 o'clock, that's David Winters, who's the author of... does it say the name of his book there? Probably not.
Yes. It does. Natural and Artificial Harmonics for the Guitar. And he will be giving a harmonics physics demonstration
right.
At 5 o'clock in the Luthier's Coffee House.
Right, and then right after that, the little Luthier's Coffee House will be the scene of a rotating slideshow by Jim McKenzie and Renee Flower.
Which will also be shown at the Arblitzer Gallery.
Yes,
as
the
well.
Actual prints, they're sponsored by Bay Photo. I've got a number of sponsors. I don't know if it's okay to talk about them. But
sure, I mean, we can say thanks.
Okay. It's just a thanks. They're all on the website. There's just a few. Sylvan Music, big shout out, thank you to them. Felton Feed and Pet Supply. Gary's Plastic, couldn't do it without you. Did I talk about Sylvan Music?
KSEO.
And KSEO gave us a wonderful sponsorship for paid advertising. And
Felton Feed.
Felton Feed and Pet Supply, yeah.
And Bay Photo.
And Bay Photo.
Of course.
Right. And Jim and Renee, I think the thing I'm most proud of, one of the things I'm most proud of about this whole journey is the way that the idea of focusing on the local luthiers inspired another couple of artists to do their own project. And they went out and photographed all of the luthiers on this list in their workshops and made these just beautiful portraits of them, and they created their own book. And so there's actually a book of luthiers that you can take home with you.
Okay. Mm. And then we have Saturday, February 8th, from lute to uke, which is when we get to hear from Ukulele Dick mm-hmm. on how a lute and a uke could be Baroque. Then February 11th, we've got a concert. February 11th, folks, that's a Tuesday at the Arblitzer Gallery. Special surprise guest. Tease us a little bit for just a second.
Well, it's somebody who's a nationally touring artist who happens to have another event in the area, and we won't be able to talk about who that is until after that performance, right?
Tuesday.
Yeah, be there.
February 11th, 8 p.m., be there at the Owl Building. Thursday, February 20th, we have Bill Walker and Chris Mallett in concert. Mm-hmm. Friday, February 21st through Sunday, February
23rd. 22nd and 23rd, sorry.
23rd is the Santa Cruz Art League, where you'll be able to have an instrument exhibit, as well as a flamenco concert by the singer Carlitos de Santa Cruz and guitarist Guillermo Rios.
Yes.
Saturday, March 1st, we've got Alex Degrassi, Evan Herschelman, and William Coulter in concert at the R Blitzer. That's at 8 p.m. And that will be the premiere performance of the Humanitar.
Yes.
I can't wait to see that. And then Thursday, March 6th, the Athens Guitar Duo in concert at the R Blitzer Gallery, plus guitarist David Winters. Thursday, March 13th, we've got the guitar poet Brian Gore in concert at R Blitzer Gallery. And then we have the ongoing at the gallery, a photographic exhibit, again, by Jim McKenzie and Renee
right.
Flower.
And if I could just add quickly that this is a nonprofit event. That's the only way I was able to pull all this together is by having nonprofit status as a sponsored project of the William James Association.
All right. So thank you. All right, Jayme Kelly Curtis, singer-songwriter. let's just talk about you for a second. Just the last few minutes of the show before we get to have now slang, new slang. Jayme Kelly Curtis, we're going to play a song of yours called Tunisia.
Okay.
And this is something that you wrote. And play?
Yes. And it's actually not on a guitar. It's on a baritone ukulele that was made by Tony Graziano, which is in an open tuning. And it has that particular instrument. I love it because the back and sides are made of koa, which is a wood that's associated with the islands. But the top is made of coastal redwood from here in our own neck of the woods, as it were, our own corner of the planet.
And so tell us a little bit about the song.
This is a song that was, it's inspired by a little bit, most of my songs are sort of semi-autobiographical, I suppose, and this one was inspired by my sixth grade substitute teacher, who had traveled from outside of our little insulated farming community and was the subject of much suspicion in our little town.
Really?
Yes.
Because they were from?
Well, she had traveled to some exotic places.
I picked the
name Tunisia, even though it's not quite literal, because I think Tunisia is, A, it's a part of deepest, darkest Africa, and people are very afraid of the other darker-skinned people. And it's also a Muslim country, and we have all that suspicion now since September 11th and... So it was, but it's an unusual, wonderful, exotic location. And so that's the name that I chose to give it to express that feeling.
And so, Jayme Kelly Curtis, you've been playing the guitar or the stringed instruments for a long time.
Mostly guitar. I also play ukulele and the dulcimer I love and a little bit of mandolin, but I can't really consider myself as Ukulele Dick would say, a virtuoso. So.
So were you, like, just starting to walk and somebody handed you a guitar or
no,
a ukulele?
No, thank you. First, you know, I've been playing for 45 years, but I was about 15.
You must have been a baby.
I was 15 when I started, so you do the math.
You look fabulous.
Thank you, dear. Remarks like that are always welcome. I had a great teacher to begin with. His name is Raleigh Brown. He lives on the East Coast, but he is a winner of the Winfield Fingerpicking Champion contest and a student of the great Reverend Gary Davis. So I was very fortunate to have some tremendous early training. But, you know, I'm delighted that you're going to play one of my songs, but I have to say, compared to the level of talent that I've brought in for this festival, I mean, I'm a minnow in the sea, so...
It's going to be beautiful. I'm thankful for you to do all of this amazing work.
Thank you,
and it's a huge amount of work you have. It's so impressive. You really outdid yourself. And we are the better for it. Jayme Kelly Curtis, thanks again for coming on. If you missed any part of the show, please go to artistonart.com. You'll be able to see a video of Jayme. I also want to thank Vanya Benavides for live tweeting and Facebooking as we've been doing the show today. And so sit back and relax, folks. This is Jayme Kelly Curtis, Tunisia.